Hey everyone, welcome back. My name's Marianne. I live in Canada with my husband and two kids, ages 3 and 4. And I make videos on simplifying motherhood through easy organization. And today's video is a grocery haul. So I'm gonna take you through, show you everything that we got for 2 weeks worth of groceries for 4 people. I'm going to share some tips and tricks and strategies that we use to manage our grocery bill. It's one of our biggest monthly expenses, and I know it is for a lot of people. We have over the years become pretty good at keeping it as low as possible. Our monthly budget is $700, and that's kind of for all groceries, all consumables. This haul was $221, I think. Again, that's for 2 weeks. We will do a top up probably halfway through. When you're looking at your grocery budget, don't be too worried about what other people spend. Everybody's family is different. Everybody's food requirements different. For example, our kids are still really small, so a lot of times they eat almost nothing for dinner. Our youngest, Annie Rose, is still in daycare, so all of her lunches are provided, so we don't have to buy for any of that. It really is a very personal expense, so don't stress too much about what other people are doing. Focus on you and just focusing on managing as much as you can with your requirements. So with that being said, let's get started. All right, so here is the whole grocery shop. That's everything, like I said, for 2 weeks for our family of 4. I'm gonna start over on this end. So we got 1 loaf of bread. We use a lot of wraps. I love these. I know some people make them themselves, but it sounds like a great idea. But for right now, we just buy our wraps. We get like one like specialty bread item. So like raisin bread or bagels or English muffins. And this week we got these dinner rolls. They're so handy. They're so yummy. And then we'll use them like with sandwiches for the kids. You put them in Leo's lunch. You can use them for sloppy joes or just as a side with a dinner with like bread and butter. This huge vinegar thing is just plain white vinegar. I'm making chili this week and I do need it for that recipe. However, we mainly just have that in the house for cleaning fruits and veggies. So all we do is soak our fruits and veggies in water and vinegar. And that's it. Like apples is a big one for us. And we just soak them in that and they're clean and good to go. Eggs, again, just standard, just have them on hand for baking or for having scrambled eggs or making quiche or something. I have a ton of canned goods this week. I'm making spaghetti sauce, I'm making chili, and I'm making like a couple hash brown casseroles. It's gonna be Thanksgiving in a couple weeks here in Canada, so I'm making the hash brown casseroles for that. Black beans, you can see for the chili. Chickpeas, I get every single week. I use these for my salads. I make salads for lunches most days, and I put these on top of my salads. You'll see like the cream of mushroom and cream of chicken soup. Those are for some casseroles. Canned stuff for our chili and our spaghetti sauce. We're having pizza tonight, so we're like doing a DIY pizza. The pizza crust that we're doing is like a specialty, it's like a local shop. I'll link it below actually. It's called Dough Mama, they're really, really good. So we'll make that tonight. Olive oil, again, we just use that for cooking and use it actually for a salad dressing is one of my big reasons of using that. Coconut oil. Okay, so this is not a budget friendly item. I rarely buy coconut oil. I know it's so good for you and I know it's super like trendy and popular right now, but I find it so expensive. So typically we don't use it. However, it's fall here in Canada, and during the fall I have this amazing pumpkin muffin recipe. Last week's video actually had it in there. If you go back and watch, it's like a fall day in the life of, and I put the whole recipe down below. But it requires this coconut oil, and it really is so good, it's worth it. But this is a splurge for us. We hardly ever buy that. Another big canned thing we do is canned fruit. So these pineapple, or we'll get peaches. I think there's like a little peach one in behind here. That's something I buy pretty much every week just to use for the kids' lunches or like top up for like say with yogurt or something. Another canned good we pretty much always get is canned tuna. That's another go-to that we use for like lunches, or we do tuna melts on it. I love tuna melts and I love tuna, so we pretty much always have that on hand. We use pickles for like a side dish or basically just a snack for the kids. These little packets, if you're on a budget and you have a ton of spices already, you can easily make this chili one or the taco one. You can easily make by yourself as well. I have made this before and it's actually so easy. But we didn't have a ton of time this week, so that's what I'm going with these ones. And then I have ranch and the gravy. Again, that's just like for a crock pot dinner I'm doing with some chicken breasts or some chicken thighs. pepperoni. We use those for the pizza that we're making tonight. And then I will save a few from here. I always save a few back, and I'm gonna use them for Leo's lunches. So I'll make like a pretend Lunchable kind of thing, like a homemade Lunchable with those. Okay, so I am not a huge meat eater myself. So these are little veggie patties, which I'll use, like I'll often have for like a dinner or something, if everyone else is having something meaty that I don't love. So for ground meat, I got two of them. So one for chili and one for spaghetti sauce. And you'll see I got pork. So ground beef in our area is pretty much always the most expensive. So we have ground pork, ground chicken, or ground beef. And I just usually get whatever's the cheapest. Pretty much all of them, like say we're making meatballs, shepherd's pie, anything like that, you can pretty much always use pork or chicken, and it tastes just as good, sometimes maybe better. When am I making my grocery list? I just put ground meat and get whichever one is cheapest. Again, for meat, chicken thighs, I got a two pack. One is for like a shake and bake dinner and one is for a crock pot dinner. I always get the chicken thighs when I'm really trying to save money, if it's like the end of the month and I don't have much budget left, I'll do it with bone in and skin on, and the chicken thighs are like for sure cheaper. Okay, so frozen veggies. This one, I almost always have these little mixed veggies, which I'll just have for a side for dinner. I've done this price comparison before, and frozen veggies in almost every case are cheaper than fresh. Diced onion and this little mix for spaghetti. Again, it's just like, basically it saves chopping. I do feel a bit guilty about the packaging because it's so much plastic. So I don't always do this, but I know that it's gonna be a busy weekend. So I got these diced onions just to save me the chopping time. So I mentioned tonight is pizza night. I did get like a really nice specialty crust, but I don't think it's gonna be enough. So I got a little frozen one to top up just so that we make sure we had enough for all four of us. As I mentioned, hash brown casserole, so good and so yummy, and everyone loves it, and super easy to make. So I'll put the recipe down below just so you have it, but I know there's like a lot of different ways to make it, but mine is pretty simple. Okay, next over here is like the dairy section. So you'll see I get almond milk. Partially I get it because I prefer it to dairy milk. However, budget wise, it lasts longer. So what I found often, like we'll get these 1 liter or whatever they are, we'll open that and it will go bad before we can finish it when it's real dairy, like when it's a dairy milk. But this almond milk, it lasts way longer. So I find that has saved us a bit of money. The sour cream, two of them, is for the hash brown casserole. This yogurt, so instead of buying like the individual package yogurts we used to buy for everyone, or even yogurt tubes, I buy just a big jug of the yogurt, and it's way cheaper and less waste than getting those individual cups. This creamer I'm totally addicted to. It's the original like coconut creamer for my coffee. Oh, it's so good if you've never tried it. Okay, butter. Butter is so expensive. It is never on sale. But if it is, I try to get a few and I'll put them in the freezer. Cheese was on sale this week, a huge, like almost half price. So I got four of them. And then I will freeze these. Last week actually was the first time I think I've ever frozen cheese, or have in a long time, and it worked totally fine. I took it out and I forgot it was even frozen. Like the consistency was totally fine. So back over here is like kind of like the breakfast stuff. Again, no name cereal is so much cheaper than brand name. Sometimes it does taste different. I will totally admit that. And I've never tried this kind. It's like obviously like a Honey Nut Cheerios knockoff, but like Honey Nut Cheerios, how can you mess that up? So we'll see. I'll let you know. This is like a guilty pleasure. These granola bars, not cheap. You'll see that we basically buy like no pre-made snacks, are not a lot, which I think is a huge money saver for us. But lately I've been totally loving these, so I just buy these for myself. I take them to work as my snack. Every week I typically do buy like one, like a cracker or something that I can just throw in Leo's lunch. And in this case, it's these veggie straws, which I know are super popular, and I find them to be a pretty good price. And apparently they're healthy. I don't know about that, but healthier, I guess. So we typically don't buy chips. However, I'm having some girlfriends over tonight, and this is going to be our snack item to go with our wine. So that's what those are for. For breakfast, I have oatmeal every single day of the week, all year pretty much. It is so easy. The kids actually really love it too. They have it a couple times a week, and it is so cheap. So toilet paper and tissues, I am considering buying, you know how you can order toilet paper that's kind of more environmentally friendly, you can order it online and have it delivered. I'm considering doing that. If you guys do that, let me know, and if you like the brand and stuff. But for now, we just get it at the grocery store and it was on sale, so I got two. So right here is our fresh produce. Bananas are a huge one for us. This is the one thing we might top up on halfway through. It's one little item of blueberries was on sale. It'll be gone probably by tomorrow morning, but it gives them a little bit of fresh fruit and it was on sale, so we got it. Celery was for some, I'm gonna use that for our spaghetti sauce, and then we'll have that with veggies and dip, kind of for a side for dinner and stuff with the kids. An onion, which I got for a recipe. Oranges for the kids' snacks. I pretty much always get at least like one melon, and pretty much cantaloupe is always the cheapest one. Some leaf lettuce, kale, and iceberg, which we'll kind of do, I'll use for my salads for the week. Green pepper I'm using for a pizza topping and also in our spaghetti sauce. Cucumber is a big one for the kids for snacks. It's both of theirs, I would say, probably their favorite for carrot or for like veggies and dip. I don't buy the baby carrots because I find them more expensive. I buy the full pack. Yes, it's kind of a pain to peel them and chop them, but I also think they taste 1,000 times better. So I find we eat them more. Visitor over here. Yeah, so that is everything, guys. That's it. That's our cute whole haul. And obviously, another huge money saver is always taking a list and always sticking to it. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope that helps. I hope that helps you save a little bit of money on your groceries this week. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Okay, everyone wants to say goodbye.
Goodbye. Bye.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching.
See you next time.